Donka Ebola Treatment Center in Conakry, Guinea. Every person who comes here to be vaccinated is first required to sign a consent form. This is because here they are running a clinical trial designed to test out the Ebola vaccine. MSF, which is taking part in the clinical trial, has already vaccinated over 1,200 people working on the front line against the disease.
Before anyone else, it's the medical staff who are the most exposed. So I recommend that everyone comes here. You never know in life. We're the ones who are in direct contact with sick people all the time. So it's essential to come and take the vaccine just in case.
Another aspect of the clinical trial consists of testing the vaccine at the homes of those who come into contact with an infected person. The first results demonstrate high effectiveness. The study will now continue, mainly to test out this vaccine on a larger cohort of people and find out how long they are protected.
Now we need to use these new findings, this new information, to help stop the virus from being transmitted as it is in Guinea and Sierra Leone. We're going to ask the various national authorities to include these new findings in the intervention approach.
Despite the Ebola epidemic having slowed down, it continues to spread at an alarming pace. In the past few months, 20 to 30 new cases a week have been recorded. A year ago, MSF alerted the international community about the urgent need to invest in action to fight this disease. Help did finally arrive in the field, but now efforts appear to be slackening off. However, until a vaccine is introduced on a wide scale, the threat will not go away. In Liberia, where the end of the epidemic was announced back in early May, 6 new cases of contamination occurred during the summer.
With the comeback of Ebola, from what I saw, the community is ready though this time. I think, other than our hospital, I think, yeah, the impact of community health promotion is going to be huge, and we need to focus on that to get some of these messages out.
The return of Ebola in Liberia may be the result of contamination by a survivor, a possibility that needs to be researched further to understand both the risks regarding transmission of the virus as well as the secondary effects victims may suffer after being declared Ebola free.
3 days ago, I started feeling pain in my joints, in my head. That's why I came to the hospital. Sometimes I can have a bad dream. Sometimes I don't sleep because when I'm thinking, I will not be able to sleep. I can't sleep.
The Ebola vaccine represents a chance to break the cycle of new transmission and bring an end to the outbreak.